The topic is estimating partial derivative using the contour diagram. All right, so let's do this example. Use the contour diagram for z equal f of xy. Question A is fx positive or negative? So let's read the definition. What do we mean with a partial derivative of f with respect to x to be positive? It is positive. It means as we move in the direction of increasing x value, this is the direction of increasing x values, what happened to the z? It increases. And then fx, partial derivative with respect to x is negative, means as we move in the direction of increasing x values, the value of z decreases. So let's see what happened if we move from increasing in the direction of increasing x values. So for example, if we go from this point to this point, this is the direction of x increasing. The z value goes from what? From 2 to 6, so it increases. Same thing, if we go from this point to this point, and then it's going to go from 6 to 10. So it's increasing. So how do we say this? As x increases, z increases. Therefore, fx is positive. Now let's do question B. Is fy positive or negative? Same thing, let's read the definition. Partial derivative of f with respect to y is positive means as we move in the direction of increasing y value, in this direction, this is the increasing y. Let me write this, increasing y. And this is increasing x values. So as we move in the direction of increasing y values, z increases. And the other way around, if z decreases, then partial derivative is less than zero. So let's take again any point. If we take this one and we move this way, we're going from z equals 6 to z equal 2. So it's decreasing. Again, if we go from here to here, you can tell z decreases from 2 to negative 2 and so on. So how do we say this? I would say as y increases, z decreases. Therefore, partial derivative with respect to y is less than 0. Now, question C, we need to estimate fx of 2, 1. Now remember, this is the formula for partial derivative with respect to x. So we're adding some h to a, and then we're keeping b to be constant. So we're trying to estimate fx of 2, 1. This is just an estimation. So it's going to be equal f of 2 plus some number, and then 1 is constant minus f of 2, 1 over that h, that number that we're going to plug in here. So which number I'm going to use? See, I'm going on the direction of x, so I'm increasing just the x value. 2, 1, first of all, is right here. So this is the point 2, 1. Right? So I'm increasing just x by some value. So I think I didn't do a very good job. Let me see. 4, 1. So yeah, so this is actually 4, 1. So if we go in this direction, from this point to this point, this is what we mean with h. H will be this number from here to here, this distance. Right? That's what we're increasing x by. The y is constant. The y is still 1. So basically, this h happened to be 4 minus 2, or 2. Let me write just 4 minus 2. And then this number happens to be the y value. The x value is what? 4. In other words, 2 plus 2. Right? So in other words, we're doing f. Let me rewrite it here. F of 4, 1 minus f of 2, 1 over 4 minus 2. Right? So in other words, I'm going to the next point that I can see what the value of the contour, like the z value. So in other words, it's kind of like a z2 minus z1 over, if you call this a z2, and you call this, which is 14, and if you call this a z1, then it's a z2 minus z1 over x2 minus x1. All right, so what is f of 4, 1? F of 4, 1 is 14, right? So it's 14 minus f of 2, 1 is 10, right? It's just the z value, right? 10 over 4 minus 2, and that should be 4 over 2, which is just 2, right? Now to estimate fy of 2, 1, now I need to go from this point to this point, right? So that will be what? Fy of 2, 1, so I'm going along y-axis. So that would be f of, what is this point? 2, 2, right? So it's f of 2, 2 minus f of 2, 1 over, now what is h? H we want from here to here. This is my h, right? This is my h when I did that. So it's 2 minus 1. So what is f of 2, 2? F of 2, 2 is the z value, which is 6. See it? 6 minus. And then f of 2, 1, it's 10 over 1, which is just negative 4. And that's it for this example.